has been a great 11 days of competition, but we're not done yet. As you look inside Herb Brooks Arena, the 1980 rink here at the Olympic Center. On this final day of competition, we'll have two hockey games for you here today. First, it will be Kazakhstan taking on Japan, the winner claiming the bronze medal, and then Canada and the United States. The bronze medal game between Kazakhstan and Japan in the men's tournament here from Lake Placid. Dekanbek. He'll get it back. Muratov. Dekanbek. Wrister deflected in. Kazakhstan power play strikes one more time. I believe that was Mukhamatov in front with the deflection. Yeah. Beautiful deflection. Yes. Puck comes right out in front. There's a bit of miscommunication between Sato and Owa. Now a chance in front. That one caught the iron. And we have another situation here of a puck going through the net. Kazakhstan asking for a review. And I think the referee says we'll get one at the next whistle. So we might have another situation as they immediately pointed at the net and Sato will hang on to it. They're going to take a look and caught iron. But the question is, did it catch the iron and go through as Sato looks back? And we'll take a look to see where this puck goes. And then the way it comes out to the right. So I feel like a bit of a forensic scientist, and we'll take a look. Yeah, there's another goal. So that is two now that are going to count that have gone through the net. Dekanbek. Picked up now here by Kazakhstan. In front, scores! Beautiful pass by Mangisbayev, and Musarov fires that one past the outstretched right pad of Sato, and it's 3-0 Kazakhstan. Beautiful feed by Mangisbayev, and Musarov makes no mistake, and Sato no chance. It is 3-0 Kazakhstan. Ooh, good save there by Sato off of Butenko, and they score! Puck loose after that initial stop by Sato. Just in the skates and kicked up ahead on Omirbekov, wrists that one up and over the glove of Sato. Nakajima dumps it in, Gavrilenko there to meet it for Kazakhstan. Puck chip up and out, now an opportunity. This is Muratov, and he scores! Short-handed goal. Butterland Muratov. As he catches up to that puck. As you can see, he just bounces right over top of Kimura, and Muratov settles the puck down, goes low, glove side, to make it 5-0 Kazakhstan. Mukhamatov will pick up the assist. His third point of the game to go along with a goal and another helper. Shot right in front. Good block there by Daniar. In front, they score! Abe takes the pass with his back to the net. You'll see it right here, and then he just quickly flips around, able to backhand it through the legs of Shutov. And Japan gets one back with under a minute to go in this second period. Koko down to Taniichi. Nice pass and a backhand. Shutov again with a big save. That one coming off of Miura. Oh, turned over right in front, scores! Ali Kasanov with the steal, able to walk right in and fired it through the legs of Nakamura. No chance as Ishida with that errant breakout attempt, and Kasanov. Back over to Batenko. Spins around to Muratov. Nice pass over here. Now Batenko up top. Muratov in front, puck loose, they score! Maxim Mukhamatov got the scoring underway in the first period. He'll get his second on the power play. Muratov just puts it to the net. And Nakamura, who had come out to challenge on that initial shot, just could not get back. A lot of traffic at the top of his crease. Kept in, but now Owa will bring it out for Japan. Puck hops a little bit there on Miata. And the other way here is Damon for Kazakhstan. Puck left, they score! Butenko joined the rush. Took the feed from Mangus Baev and rifles it by Nakamura. And it's 8-1. And that one goes under the glove of Nakamura. Back in behind the net. Kimura will gather it here for Japan. And for Kazakhstan. It is a bronze medal here at the Lake Placid 2023 FISU World University Games as they defeat Japan 8-1. Live from the Olympic Center and Herb Brooks Arena, it is the gold medal game of the Lake Placid 2023 FISU World University Games. You can see crowd continues to file in here at the Olympic Center for this matchup between rivals Canada and host United States. Neighbors, but big rivals on the ice. The Canadian roster, led by Captain Jared Dimitru, and Jonathan Yantzis and Brett Davis for the United States. Captain Brendan Mark had that big marker in the first period yesterday. Luca Quaro leads them in goals and points with 6 and 11 respectively. And we are underway. The final sporting event of these Lake Placid 2023 FISU World University Games. Gold medal on the line between Canada and the U.S. Canada in the red with the black and white, as mentioned, the U.S. in the white, the blue shoulders and blue numbers. And early chance of USA, USA go up here at Herb Brooks Arena. Kent tries to get it up the boards. Kept in by the U.S. Now Dimitri, he's away with Levine. Dimitri into the corner. Canada comes out with it. That shot for rebound. Oh, good save. Right pad by Kenny. Off that rebound that he couldn't find immediately. That'll be an icing call. Nope, they wave it off. It was waved off late by the... Here's that rebound out in front, and Levine could not get it up and over. Great reaction by Ryan Kenny. Now chip up and out. Noah King gives race chase against Peter Morgan. That shot attempt blocked. Now Morgan back to the blue line. Ring lost it, and the U.S. will reset. Here's Green, nice little pass there to Morgan. Shot good save by Edmonds, his first of the game. Yances tried to find LaFrance. Now here is Jonathan Yances, two goals in yesterday's game. Yances shot right on, and Ryan Kenny will gather up that rebound and hang on to it. Ryan Kenny has had to make two or three big saves already. This is the first save for Edmonds, and a nice one too as the U.S. sprung Morgan free. Another look at that left pad save. So both goaltenders having to come up with some stops in the early going. Bergeron, that shot in, deflects into the corner. Chipped up by the U.S. Backhanded as far as the blue line. Bergeron, that one they score! Justin Bergeron put it right on net. And the deflection eludes Ryan Kenny, and Canada has a 1-0 lead.
Team USA penalty.
Here's LaFrance. Switches spots. Bergeron tried to feed him. Now they get it to LaFrance. Bergeron, sweet pass, and they score! Brett Davis on a beautiful feed from Justin Bergeron. And Canada on the power play will take a 2-0 lead. So that cross seam pass, and Davis with time to unload that wrister. Shields gets it up ahead, turned over, Coxhead now for Canada. Shields did a big run at him and just missed. Puck turned over nearly in front. And now a 3-on-1 for the U.S. Shot, oh, and a blocker save off Matt Hannawall. Great pass by Malera. And at that end of the ice, some big saves. Now Canada back, 3-on-1 themselves. And a blocker save, a glove save, I should say, by Kenny. Pass in front. Richard couldn't get anything on it. Aquaro for the U.S. cuts in. Edmonds steers that one aside. Walensky shot blocked. Much better start here for the Americans. Nifty little move there by Struthers. Gets it out of danger. Here's Howell. He'll backhand it into the U.S. zone. Struthers on it. Behind Keating, puck comes right in front as it bounced off the side of the net. So big saves on back-to-back 3-on-1s. Malera with this pass to Hannawall, and a blocker saved by Kai Edmonds, and then moments later a 3-on-1 back the other way, and Bergeron is denied by the glove of Ryan Kenny. Thank you. finds Gilmore. A pop, Bergeron shot right on, stopped by Kenny, rebound in front. And now Gilmore, 35 seconds to go in the power play. Here's LaFrance down low. Bergeron to LaFrance, shot blocked. That one stung, but she stayed in the lane. Gilmore to LaFrance, hard shot. Blockered away by Kenny. And that will likely do it. Good penalty killing by the U.S. Some good chances for Canada. Shane. And they score shortly after the power play ends. It is Kyle Bowler's 3-0 Canada. TJ Shea with a nifty little play at the just outside the U.S. blue line. As he saw that puck coming around, just lifted the stick, and that allowed Canada to get away on the 2-on-1, and Bowlers finishes it off. It is 3-0 Canada. Highland in behind the net. Walford will activate from the point. He'll backhand it in behind the net. Swift there for the U.S. Good work by Canada down low. Levine loses it. He'll kick it up. Now in front. Oh, and just shot wide on the backhand by Dimitriou. Made a good play to open himself up. Penalty upcoming to the U.S. Shot by Levine. That one goes wide. Extra attacker out. It's Howell for Canada. And here he is with the puck. Down low, Howell. Pop Walford. That shot deflected, they score! Noah King, I believe, in front of the net. Able to deflect that Walford shot as Canada had the extra attacker on the delayed penalty. And it is King, giving Canada a 4-0 lead. Canada does a good job to keep the puck alive with the extra attacker. The U.S. could not gain possession. Big faceoff win there for the U.S. And Swift does a good job to get it out. Now a 2-on-1 for the U.S. Shot scores! A 5-on-3 shorthanded marker for the United States to bring this crowd to life. LaFrance tried to deflect it, but it resulted in a 2-on-1, and it's Ruffin who scored the huge overtime winner yesterday. And Ruffin cashes in here shorthanded for the U.S. Shot, they score. Canada gets it right back. Adam McCormick, power play goal, Team Canada. No chance for Ryan Kenny. I don't think he ever saw it. Off the bar and in. Dimitriou cuts in. Got a shot away. McPherson able to chip it in, and Levine rubs Palmer out of the play. Now Davis. He'll come around, fires that one high off the shoulder of Kenny, who will cover it up. Shots 36-11 in favor of Canada. And we'll see Dimitriou just gets a step on Palmer, cuts in front. Initial shot not there, but right here just able to bank it towards the net. McChesney on the draw against Coxed. Puck kept in by Ring. 14 minutes, 20 seconds. One timer scores! Brendan Mark on the power play. 5-2 now for Canada. And the U.S. will still have a minute 49 to go in the man advantage. Just a bullet shot on the setup from Ring. Broussard now back up top. Here's McCormick. Wrister. That shot blocked by McChesney. Shot in, and again they score. The glove of Ryan Kenny had come up. I don't think the referee saw that. Normally that would be blown down. I don't think he saw that, and the puck ends up banked in behind Ryan Kenny. You'll see a good look at it here. The wrister from McCormick, and the glove comes right off, and the referee, you can see, looking in behind, and then that puck gets chipped off the skate and in. Canada has only failed to medal once the previous 17 times that they have played hockey at the FISU World University Games. That was in 2005 in Innsbruck, where they finished fifth. But for Canada, it will be their fifth goal, and there's their seventh goal with just 6.4 seconds left. Tyler Hyland leads the celebration down the Canadian bench. It's a quick wrister up and over the glove of Kenny. Fourth for Hyland. And that will do it. Team Canada, gold medalist in men's hockey at the Lake Placid 2023 FISU World University Games. And there you look at the Canadian bench. Gardner McDougall, third gold medal as head coach of Team Canada at the FISU World University Games. Again from Lake Placid, Canada, gold medalist in men's hockey.